The Met Department is calling this a typical drought year. Rains are not only deficient, but the monsoon is also expected to withdraw by early mid-September. Already, as many as 161 districts have been declared drought hit. And the government is not worried, as the dry spell could damage the Rabi crop and drive up prices on essential commodities.
Basically, 2009, and of course, therefore, the 2009-10 Rabi harvest is going to be under pressure. Kharif is certainly going to be below par. And it really depends how the rest of the month pans out, rest of August and early September pans out, how much water pressure will be there on the Rabi harvest. I mean, this is not good news. That's absolutely true.
Agriculture Minister Sharad Pawar says sugarcane and pulses output would be hit massively and the situation is serious. Oil seeds sowing from June 1 is down 7.3% from a year ago. Rice sowing is down 19%. Poor farm produce is also likely to bring down the demand for consumer goods and services, which in turn could reduce non-farm income, thereby putting pressure on the output.
As far as the agriculture's contribution to GDP growth rate per se is concerned, I don't think that if it is taken on a standalone basis, it wouldn't have a very major impact. But having said that, it is not never on a standalone basis.
Some still believe adequate rainfall in certain parts of the country, coupled with industrial growth, may more than make up for the fall in agricultural output.
Our research analyst, who recognizes that agricultural output falling can have an effect on GDP growth, has actually said as of now, we are not changing our outlook, which is 8% for next year.
Most experts say that the government should embark on a plan to bail farmers out in case of crop failure. They're not expecting another farm loan waiver, but say the government may help farmers get new loans at lower interest for the next crop. With Unni Krishnan and Sujata Goel, this is Vishank Chandavarkar, UTVI, Mumbai.